Freeform planning enables you to deploy an application with no dimension requirements. The open dimensional solution allows you to create an application with a cube that follows a dimension combination required by your organization. Like a custom or module-based planning business process, you can load data and create artifacts to help you analyze and work on your plans. For other videos on how to create freeform applications, visit docs.oracle.com. In this tutorial, I'll analyze plans using multiple grids in SmartView by performing ad-hoc actions in a freeform application. I'll start by setting SmartView behaviors and settings. For SmartView suppression behavior, I'll set it to standard. This suppresses rows or columns containing no data or missing and all zeros or a combination of both. Setting the SmartView ad-hoc behavior enables enhanced ad-hoc features. Let's take a look at how my data displays in a dashboard. My dashboard displays a form that tracks profit per product in several scenarios and periods. A chart displays the same data and is updated when data is changed in the form. I'll open my form in SmartView. The form is opened with the planning ribbon selected. To start performing ad hoc analysis, click Analyze. I'll switch to a blank worksheet and connect using shared connections. I'll turn off data suppression to make sure I can retrieve all data rows even if they contain missing data or zeros. I'll connect to my freeform application cube and enable ad hoc analysis. You can also enable ad hoc analysis by right-clicking on the cube in the SmartView panel and selecting ad hoc analysis. You can plan with multiple ad hoc grids for multiple data sources on one worksheet. Before inserting grids, make sure that you set options for SmartView behaviors in all your data connections. I'll move my freeform applications grid towards the bottom of the worksheet. Next, select an area in the worksheet where you want to insert a new grid. Each grid can be connected to a different data source. When prompted, select to use the sheet for multiple grid ad hoc. A grid for the financials cube is added to the worksheet. I'll insert a grid for my financial close cube. In-sheet POV is available for each grid. Use Member Selector to select members for each POV dimension. You can also enter the member name in the POV cell, grid row, or grid column to set the POV. I quickly made selections for each of my grids. The ad hoc ribbon includes ad hoc actions you can perform to analyze and manage data. The same options are made available in the right-click menu. I'll hide the SmartView panel and set the ribbon to auto-hide and start performing ad hoc analysis on multiple grids. Double-click members to drill down. I'll change the scenario for this grid by replacing the name of the member on a row and then selecting Keep Only. I can zoom in to the bottom level to retrieve data for the lowest level of product members. Then, I can work on this grid and use Keep Only to select an entity. I can move dimensions to the POV by right-clicking it and dragging it to the POV row. By double-clicking a dimension in the POV, you move it to the row. You can also pivot a member from the row to the column. With Remove Only, I can select which members I want to exclude in the grid. Easily perform ad hoc actions for multiple grids until your sheet displays the data you need. With multiple grid ad hoc, you can submit data from any grid on the worksheet. Each grid is independent. Submit data for only one grid at a time. Then, to display updated data in the sheet, click Refresh. For more information and submit data options, see the Oracle SmartView for Office User's Guide. Reduce reporting maintenance by using your freeform application as a reporting application and by analyzing data using multiple grids in SmartView. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.